Good morning, students. Today in EVS, we are going to start lesson number 10, More About Water. In our previous lessons, we have learned that water is important for all living things and the sources of water. From where do we get water? Now, today we are going to learn some more properties about water. Now, look at this picture. You can see a milk bottle. What is the color of the milk? It is white. Now here you can see a glass of orange juice. Now what is the color of the juice? It is orange in color. Now take some clean water in a glass. Look at its color. What color is it? You'll say it doesn't have any color. Smell a fragrant flower. Any flower, mogra flower, rose flower. Did you like the smell? Yes, the smell. It smells sweet. The fragrance is sweet. Now, if you take a ripe mango or a chiku, a guava. Now, what does it taste? It tastes sweet. Now, taste the water. How does it taste? It doesn't taste. There is no taste. So what does this tell us? This tells us that pure water has no color, no taste or smell. So this is the property of water. Pure water has no color. It is colorless. It has no smell. It is odorless. It is tasteless. Now we are going to see another property of water. There are two new terms, transparent and opaque. You can see in the picture, children. A boy is sitting in front of a table and there is a candle. And a cardboard is there in between the boy and the candle. Now, the boy cannot see the candle burning on the other side of the cardboard. Now, look at the same candle. If you keep a glass in front of the candle, you can see the candle. Now, what does this tell us? This tells us that you can see the flame through the, you cannot see the flame through the cardboard, but you can see it through the glass. This tells us that the cardboard is opaque, but the glass is transparent. So, if you can see through a substance, it is said to be transparent. If you cannot see through a substance, it is said to be opaque. Children, one more property of water is that water takes the shape of the container into which you pour it. Water does not have a shape of its own. That is why it spreads when it spills on the floor. Now, we are going to see the three states of water. State means the form in which a substance is found. So, there are three states of water. Solid state, liquid state, and gaseous state. We are going to see one by one each state of water. Now this experiment you can try, but under the supervision of an adult, your parent or any adult. Now what you have to do is heat some water on a burner. What do you see? After some time the water begins to boil. Now when we boil water, after some time you can see steam coming out from the water. Afterwards, place a lid on the beaker or the container, and after some time remove the lid. What do you see on the underside of the plate? You can see droplets of water have formed on it. Now, from where does these drops of water come on the lid? When water is heated, it starts boiling, and when it is cool, when it starts cooling, it freezes. Now, when water becomes very cold, it freezes. Like when we have to make ice in the refrigerator, we freeze the water, and after some time, it turns into ice. So, when water becomes very cold, it freezes and it turns into ice. When that ice is left uncovered, it gets heat from the air around it and it starts melting. That is, it forms water. When water gets enough heat, like when we boil the water, it again turns into vapor. So the boiling water in the experiment turned into vapor. That is why the water in the beaker was reduced. And then as steam cools, it turns into water. The plate held on in the steam was cool. So the steam that collected on its underside cooled down and droplets of water were formed. So this way, water changes its state from solid to liquid. The solid state of water is ice, then liquid state, and when liquid, and then water, when again the water is heated, it changes its state into gaseous. That means it forms vapor. The steam that is coming out is the gaseous state of water. So there are three states of water. Solid state, example of solid state is ice. Liquid state, example of liquid state is water. And gaseous state. So water vapor is the example of gaseous state of water. Now children, take a glass. Wipe it dry inside and outside with a clean piece of cloth. Place 5 to 6 ice cubes in the glass. You will see that the glass becomes wet on the inside, but you see that the outside of the glass also become moist. What does this tell us? The air around the glass contains water vapor. When we put ice cubes in the glass becomes cold. That makes the air around the glass cold too. The water vapor in the air also cools and forms very tiny droplets of water. They make the glass moist. Children, water has to be frozen to make ice. Many people have refrigerators in which ice can be made. In factories, ice is made in large quantities. Ice candy or ice fruit is made by freezing water to which sugar, fruit juice, and color have been added. Do you all know, children? Due to the cold, the coconut oil in the bottle has frozen. We have to pour it out. Now, how can we pour it out? How can we do this? When that frozen coconut oil is given some heat, this solid state is converted into liquid state. Therefore, we can either keep the frozen bottle of coconut oil in the sun, or we can dip it in hot water. The oil will melt and it can be poured out. Always remember, children, we know that liquid water has many uses, but the solid ice and the gaseous water vapor are also useful in many ways. Now, what we have learned in this lesson? Water has no color, smell, or taste. Water is transparent. Water takes the shape of the container in which it is kept. Water spreads on a flat surface. It flows down a slope. Water is found in three states: solid, liquid, and gaseous. Several substances dissolve in water.